When we jump, they jump. All the mother girls tryna be like us. Oh, oh, can't get it done. Tryna soak it up, can't get enough.
It's insane. It's kind of hard for me to wrap my head around all this. Like, sometimes for me, I wake up, I'm like, wait, this is not real. Everyone knows my name. I will go outside and I'll have like fans come up to me and go, oh my God, you're not the person to handle. Ah! And I'll freak out. Or it's such a beautiful moment. And I'm just loving each and every moment of it. I truly am. It's been beautiful. It's been great.
Just soaking it all up. We know from the first season.
Absolutely.
Recorded it quite far in advance. Can you let us know like when this was actually recorded?
Yes. So towards the end of November, mid-November to late December. Yeah.
Okay, so not too far in the past.
Nope.
And the premise of the show, if anyone hasn't watched it, is basically a bunch of really attractive people from all over the world join together on this island for what they think is a show about partying and hooking up. But when you get there after a few hours, you're told the news by Lana, who is basically a robot, that you have to abstain from sex, any kissing, any heavy petting for the whole time that you're there. And it seems like a huge shock to a lot of people who normally would be on it very, very quickly.
Did you
really believe this was for a completely different show, or is that all?
Oh, no. Oh, my gosh. So we get this question a lot, and I can tell you 100% we did not know at all. Some of us had our suspicions, but we were thrown off because we saw a production team went the far extent to wearing shirts that said Parties in Paradise crew, and they had the Parties in Paradise hats. So we were like, oh yeah, there's no way this is too hard to handle. Because they went that far to like make us believe that we were on like a whole different show. So we were like, oh yeah, we're going to get drunk. We're going to like go crazy and party. I'm like, yeah, it's time to turn up. All of a sudden, we're sitting there, we're in our costumes. We're like, yeah, we look good. This dramatic robot comb shaped thing comes out of the ground with fog. I'm like, she knows how to make an entrance.
Yeah.
And then lo and behold, it's Lana.
And you knew from that point, because you'd seen season one, you were like,
yes,
okay, this is really happening.
Oh my God. Yep. When I saw the peak of the cone, not even the whole shape, I'm like, I know exactly what this is. And my jaw dropped. I'm like, I can't do this.
I like to think that maybe any other time, yeah, it might be quite hard. You know, they're all really like young, active people. But we saw your kind of journey, and any spoiler alerts, like ended as a couple and telling each other, you know, that you wanted to carry this on outside of the show. Where do we stand now? What's the latest? Like a good couple of months on?
Oh, so a few months on. Marvin and I are not together. We haven't been together for a while since the show. And we haven't been able to see each other because he's in Paris and I'm in New York City. So the quarantine and then the travel restriction, it just wasn't going to work. Mm-hmm. So, and then like, I barely talked to him. He barely talked to me. So it was really difficult, but I'm in a place where I'm happy now and he's happy. And I want nothing but the best for him. Honestly, he's on a great path to success and I wish him nothing but the best.
When you say he's on a great path to success, do you think like we've kind of seen now that this might not have been the only reality show that done of late? And I think a lot of us, you know, when it's our ex or a fling or someone that we've been with, I wish you the best and like I want nothing but good stuff for you.
Yeah.
Can I ask, like, do you really mean it or is it just like?
Oh, no, I mean it 100%. We're all on our own separate path. We're all on our own journey. So I can't judge someone because of their past or their shows they've been on. I judge them for how they treated me and the impact they had on me. Towards the end of the show, Marvin made a big impact on me. And I was very, very grateful that I met him. But as the months went on, it was like, you know, this is not going to work. And it's okay. It's okay.
And life must be so different from being on this, like, amazing.
Oh, yeah.
I mean, it's jobless as well. Everyone is unemployed during that time. And you're being wined and dined. So, coming back. Did it kind of hit you, not just your relationship with Marvin at the time, but, you know, just adjusting to reality? Because everyone around you doesn't know what you've kind of been through.
100. Oh my gosh. It took me about 2 weeks to come back to normal because when we're on the show, we didn't have a phone. We didn't have a sense of time. So for me to come back, and again, you're on an island, a gorgeous island. You got a breathtaking views and you're surrounded by singles and fun people. And then to go back to, for me, New York City, where there's quarantine, it's cold. You can't see your family and friends because of this whole COVID. You're paranoid. So it's like, it was kind of depressing for me to just kind of just go from this happy place back to this pandemic that we're all going through. So it was actually really hard.
And did it feel like then there's a big switch once the kind of preparation for the show coming out, it's like that excitement ramped up again?
Yes. Yeah. Like once we were getting closer to the release date, it was like, okay, we're about to do this. Like, so it was getting more and more exciting as the days were coming. And I was like, oh yeah, this is actually feeling real now.
Yeah. And do you stay in touch with many of the other kind of cast members?
I do.
I really want to know, do you have like a group WhatsApp group?
Yes. Yes, we are all connected and on Instagram in a group chat called THTH. Yeah, so we all keep in contact. We keep each other updated. We want to all get together and go to like a vacation and kind of do like our own little reunion. So we're actually thinking about doing something soon.
Nice.
Like everyone lives across the world, so it's kind of hard. Larissa is in New Zealand and Mara's in Paris and I'm in New York City. So it's kind of hard to get everyone together and work around everyone's schedule. Now that the show is out, everyone is definitely booked and busy now. So it's really hard.
Yeah. Speaking of being booked and busy, like I have to say, between me and my friends who've been watching it, have all had our own kind of ideas of where we'd love to see you in different places. Like we can't do with like a character like you being on this one show and then, okay, that's the end. We don't see you again. Bye. And it does worry me. I sometimes think of the people on your Netflix screen as
absolutely.
We want to see more things from you, basically.
100%, yeah.
And so I'd love to hear where you kind of like this journey to go, or like a few ideas, and then I'll tell you what we have in mind for you, if you don't
mind. Awesome. So for me personally, what I want to see and do after this whole experience, I want to see myself on another billboard. Cause that was my biggest dream, was to be on the billboard. And it happened with the whole Too Hot to Handle and me and the crew. But for me, I want to do like a commercial for CoverGirl. I want to be on a billboard for Sephora. I want to be in the Sephora stores as a face. I want to be a spokesmodel for Lancome or a brand ambassador. I want to be just that person who inspire young girls all around the world to show them, hey, do not let fear and discouragement tell you no. Do not. Keep your head high, wear your crown high, and always, always, always believe in yourself. So I want to be that person to have a big impact on the younger communities, especially women.
We need that. And like, I can see it, you know, it's not just through looks and beauty and
yeah,
confidence in a way.
Exactly.
That, you know, can't be bought.
Yeah, you got to dig it from here in the heart, inside.